Before you watch the video, make sure to print out the video fill-in notes below. Way number one on how to pass the Algebra 1 Common Core Regents. When rearranging formulas, you'll want to do the opposite operation on the other side. To see what this means, let's look at the following question from the January 2016 Algebra 1 Regents. Michael borrows money from his uncle, who is charging him simple interest using the formula I equals PRT. Michael is then asked to rearrange the formula to solve for R. Since R is being multiplied by P and T in the current formula, we'll need to divide I by P and T on the other side to get R by itself. In this next question from the January 2015 Algebra 1 Regents, don't let the different formula throw you off. Once again, we need to rearrange the formula to solve for R, so do the opposite operation on the other side, dividing V by pi and H, which will effectively eliminate the three choices that don't reflect this. The answer will be choice 1, because in order to get rid of the square, you need to take the square root of the whole formula on the other side, which is the opposite operation. And just in case you need help with short answer questions, question 35 from the August 2015 Algebra 1 Regents asked the same exact thing. Just make sure to write out the full equation. Another variation of this question appeared on the June 2014 Algebra 1 Regents, but this time had one-third thrown into the mix. Once again, rearranging for R, do the opposite operations on the other side, including multiplying V by 3 to get rid of the one-third. Finally, take the square root of the entire formula to get rid of the square, making the answer choice 1. And even if they decide to change the letters and numbers around on you, like they did here on the June 2015 Algebra 1 Regents, the same concept still applies. To solve for T, move A to the bottom of the other side, eliminating choices 1 and 3. Multiply D by 2 to get rid of the 1/2, and then take the square root of the whole formula to get rid of the square, making the answer choice 2. And to sum it all up, we'll use this question from the August 2014 Algebra 1 Regents, where they give you the formula for a trapezoid. Since we need to isolate B1, we'll move H to the bottom of the other side and multiply the A by 2 to get rid of the 1/2. And since B2 is added to B1, we'll need to do the opposite operation on the other side. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.